Hi students, right? In this session, we are going to discuss with respect to effective atomic number. Okay. Effective atomic number. It is also known as PAN rule. Effective atomic number rule. Or it was proposed by something like Sidney, so it is also called as Sidney theory. Very simple, this is a single line statement. Whatever he says is, he has said that if all the electrons around the central atom after gaining electrons. If all electrons from the central atom after gaining electrons from the ligand is equal to the atomic number of next energy gas, it is stable. Simple. Right. Let us say scandium, titanium, beryllium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, zinc. So this entire set, okay, that entire set belongs to which period? Which period? Third period? 3D series, right? So in this 3D series, what happens? It goes on like this. Last one giving something like krypton atomic number is success. Okay. See, scandium series is 3D series because electrons third period. Okay. 3D series will be starting from here. So it belongs in 3D series. If you go on like this, what will be the last energy gas? So let me see here. 3D series, okay. Before this, what will be getting? Calcium, this is potassium. You go for sodium, hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium. So it is fourth period. Okay? Fourth period will be having 3D series. 3D series will be starting from here. So the last atomic number is 36. Right? Here we will be getting 30. From here we have 6 classes. Hydrogen, helium, neon. Sorry, helium, neon will be getting here. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, neon. This is here. On. That is 4. Right? So the last one will be krypton atomic number is 36. Again, I am repeating. The central atom generally, if you take from 3D series, the atomic number last in that respective period will be 36 here. Okay? Right. What he is saying is this, if all the electrons are on the central atom, let me take central atom like iron. I am taking something like iron. Okay? How many electrons will be present? Either it may be atom or iron. Something like 26. 26. What is it? If all the electrons are on the central atom, you are having the central atom electrons. After gaining the electrons from the ligand, suppose you are having some ligands, you are having cyanide 6. So each ligand gives how many electrons? 2 electrons, right? So how many electrons you get in here? 2. So what I was told is 36. Means 36 is what? It is the atomic number of krypton. So if any atom is having electrons or having electrons around it after gaining electrons from the ligand, if it is equal to the next energy gas. If the gained electrons is equal to total electrons plus gained electrons, if it is equal to the atomic number of the next energy gas, then that molecule will be stable. Clear? You are having a central atom, it is having some electrons. Plus electrons gained from the ligands. If the total electrons are equal to the next energy gas configuration or next energy gas atomic number or next energy gas electrons, then that complex is stable. That is what this series is. That is itself Sidney theory. Okay? The central atom electrons plus electrons gained from the surrounding ligands. The if they are equal to the next metal gas. Okay. Suppose if you take something like here, it will be starting from yttrium, something like zirconium, niobium, molybdenum, technetium, you will meet cadmium. Okay, for this series, what should be? The electrons should be return, it should be zero. Okay? So, the number of electrons of this one is one, then it's going to be niobium. Niobium electrons should be equal to the number of electrons of xenon. Right, how much it should be? Something like if you add 18. It should be equal to 54. 54 electrons should be present, then that will be stable. Clear? So let us say for examples, I hope that we are getting this. The number of electrons of the central atom and the number of electrons gained from the surrounding electrons. If they are equal to the next coming in the gas configuration, then the properties will be stable. Right? So first example let me take. That is K4 Fe CNC. Calculate the number of electrons for this one. So, first what you should do, then you are having outside one more thing, right? So, you should make it into ions. Make that compound into ions. So, what you will be getting? Fe, CN6 minus 4, here 4 K+. Nothing to bother about this one, only one that. You want this one, whether this one calculate the effect or not, remember, means. So, first go for the calculation of iron. What is the oxygen state of iron? So, x plus 6 times of minus 1, sin x is minus 1, minus 4, x minus 6 equal to minus 4, x is equal to plus 2. Wow. You have got plus 2. Means, what does that indicate? That indicates iron is in plus 2 state. Generally, iron, what is the configuration? 4s2, 3d, 6. So, what is the configuration of this one? It is something like 26. But you are having what? You are having Fe plus 2. So it is 26 minus plus 2 is you should give 2. You are having plus 2. So it is minus 2. This is clear. So how many electrons are there? 24. For Fe plus 2 you are having 24 electrons. Okay? 24 electrons. And how many cyanides you are having? Each cyanide donates 1 lone pair. Means each cyanide donates 2 electrons. So 6. See, 6 cyanides. It is nothing but 6 into 2 electrons will be equal. So, what is the sum? This is 36 electrons. So, this is the effective atomic number. So, what you can say? 24 plus 12, 36 electrons. The next energy gas is. What is that? Krypton, atomic number of krypton is 36. So, this complex is stable. Okay? What is the use? We can find the stability of the molecules. Right? If I take one more example. See, CO, NH3, taking 6 steps, plus 3. So, calculate the head to atomic number of this molecule. So, this is X, plus 6 times of 0, is equal to, plus 3, X is equal to, plus 3, cobalt. Generally, cobalt is 27. So, it is plus 3. So, cobalt plus 3 is, you will be getting 24. So, how many electrons NH3 are there? So, NH3 are having 6. So, it is 6 into 2 electrons, because this line is the next. Electrons, more DNA like that. So it will be good. What so total is 36. So this molecule is stable. Okay? So let me take one more molecule like indium tetracarbonyl. Okay? What is the oxidation state of nickel in this complex? So nickel is like this x plus 2 times of 0 is equal to 0, x is equal to 0. So nickel is generally 28, no oxidation state, it is nothing. Okay, carbonyl, 4 times of CO, it is 4 into 2, so it will be getting 8. So it is 36. So that is electrons, it is stable. Getting me? Right, take the same way, nickel, tetracyanide, minus 2. But then we have tried to solve this question. Okay, so nickel is X. 4 times of minus 1 is equal to minus 2. X minus 4 is equal to minus 2. X is equal to what? Plus 2. So, nickel is 28. You have plus 2. Means here minus 2. So, it is 26. Cyanide how many are there? 4 cyanides. Means 4 into 2. It is 8. So, you are getting 34 electrons. So, this compound is not stable. So, the effective atomic number of this compound is 34. So, that compound is not stable. Right? Let us take one more example like FeCl6 minus 3. Try to calculate the secret of the number of this particular complex. Right, what happens here? So they have predicted that it is not stable. Okay, let us take one more example, the last example for this one. So let me take this K2 platinum series. Okay, this is platinum, right? Dissociation. Platinum Cl6 minus 2, 2K plus. Okay? We will make it this one. We should find out for this one, right? So platinum is plus 6 times of minus 1 is equal to minus 2. X minus 1 is equal to x minus 6 is equal to minus 2. X is equal to plus 4. So platinum, general rate is 78. Platinum atomic number is 78. Platinum plus 4 means 78 minus 4 is 74. Okay? Platinum atomic number is 78. Right, go for the number of platinum. How many are there? 6. 6 into 2, so it will be 12. So it is 86. 86 is the atomic number of radon. Radon is a metal gas. So this complex is very stable. Right, these are the things what they have derived, what they have said with respect to the theory. But controversy to this theory, there are some molecules which are stable even though they doesn't have any nearest kinetic gas configuration. Let us see some examples of that man. Okay? See, this theory is accepted, but as the time is going on, they have formed some molecules. Even though they are not getting the kinetic gas configuration, they are very stable. Right? Like exception molecules. MnCO5, I think that MnCO5. So let us say manganese CO5. This is the molecule. So how many electrons are there? What is the electron number? So X plus 5 times of 0 is equal to 0. X is equal to 0. So manganese is in nothing state, so it is 25 plus 5 carbonyls. 5 carbonyls is 10 electrons, so it is 35 electrons. Even though it is not having 36 electrons, it is stable. Okay, so this is an exception. Like, and one more thing, this is strong oxidizing agent. This is acting as a strong oxidizing agent and is very stable even though it is having 35 electrons. It is violated in the Cyclic theory. Right, there is one more molecule like CrCOA. So, CrCOA. Okay, so go for this one, chromium. So let us go for the opposite state. This is X plus 8 times of 0 is equal to 0, X is equal to 0. Okay, so what are you doing? Chromium, nothing problem. Scandium, gallium, arsenide, bromide is 24. 24 plus ligands, how many are there? 8. Let me take CO, so 8 to 16. So this is 12. It's not right. 12, 10, 12. So this is a small electrons, but this molecule is stable. Okay, CrCO take it 8 times. It also acts as something like oxidizing agent, chromium octacarbonyl complex. Right? Next example will be going vanadium CO6 minus. So write the calculator. Vanadium CO6. This complex is, I hope that this will be having 36 electrons. Let us see. Yes. Plus 6 times of 0 is equal to minus 1. X is equal to minus 1. Right. Scandium is 23. Minus 1 is plus 1 is 4.
5 only, 5 into 2 is the electrons.
have the same number of electrons. So, if the same number of electrons are there, according to atomic structure, what do you call them? Isoelectronic species. So, all these are isoelectronic. These two are isoelectronic in nature. Right? If the hydration is also same, then we can call them as isostructural also. If same hydration or if same structure is present, then isostructural, same electron, isoelectronic. Again, I am saying,
once you check over that, so trigonal bipyramidal structure, the molecule looks like this. structural and isoelectronic with each other.
See, what's the typical body symmetry theory? Symmetry theory says that the total number of electrons around the central atom after gaining electrons from the ligand, it is equal to the atomic number of the next coming inert gas, then that molecule is stable. But there are some molecules which are stable even though they doesn't have electronic configuration or number of electrons that are equal to the next inert gas. Like we have seen something like 35 electron molecules. And next, the concept we have learned is isostructural and isoelectronic. Isoelectronic means same number of electrons in the atom, as well as isostructural means same structure will be present. Based on the ligand, you can say structure, and based on the gathering of ligand, number of electrons, you can say isostructural. These are the things what we have learned till now. Okay, students? Okay, students, let me erase this thing.
Okay, based on the strong field, you can select this. If it is weak field,
this one is equal to 1. This is the energy balance. This is the total balance. From this balance, this point is extra. From this balance, this is minus 1 for lesser. Okay? Now I am going for this one. Tetrahedral complexes. Tetrahedral complexes, 5 are there. 3, 4, 5.
Okay.
When the ligand comes, the energy level has been increased. Still, ligand comes. It dissociates in this time.
So, whatever heat you are getting here in the bottom side, here you can get the numerator side, means
top side.
EG, you are getting top side, isn't it? But G means gerade, T means tetrahedral. This is uniform identity.
Okay, don't. See, here you can get this only E.
Not EG.
This one, T,
or in no G. Okay, getting me?
This is E, this is T.
So, can I only alter here in EG what are present?
EG means B, X square, Y square, B Z square.
These are the alters you can see in EG here.
B X Y, B Y Z, B Z X.
These are the alters you can see in this. But here, same.
B x square y square, B z square. These are the numbers that you can get in the bottom side. And this one, B x y, B y z, B z. These are the things you can have on the top. So, the reverse is splitting in this case. So, what you can see here? There is something like how many are present here? Top side.
Generally present here,
then how many are present here? 2. So it is plus 0.4. So you can say 2 by 5. Here it is 3 by 5. This is minus 0.6.
But tetrahedral complexes will be learning like this. Okay.
This is the splitting energy of octahedral. So this difference in energy, it is called as delta. See, energy difference in tetrahedral complex. Here, energy difference in octahedral complex. Okay, this is the way of splitting. Suppose if you go for this square planar. Okay, so generally it is like this 5 raising energy, 5 degree terms.
See, these are 5 degree terms. When the approach of ligand starts, starting all will be raising the equal energy level. After that, what happens? This energy level,
when the approach is very clear, what happens is this is B, x square by x square. On the something like this. This is something like linear to linear to here. Still, this one B x square, y square, and this is B z square. When the ligand approach still closer, the square plane are not in that complex. Not in that complex, as well as octahedral. Only the square plane of complex. This energy level, B, X, Y, B, something like 3 are finished, B, Y, Z, B.
Okay. Right, this is the energy levels that you can see in the square planar complex. So the highest energy level, so the order of energy levels is B x square y square greater than B x y greater than B z square greater than B y z is equal to B z x. So this is the way of energy levels. So after we have a higher energy, this is the order of from here to the beginning of. The next levels. That is the square plane of complex. In this, same in P2, what are having? DXY, DYZ, DZX. All these are equal. So I can write like this DXY equal to DYZ equal to DZX greater than DX square Y square equal to DZ square. So this is the way of thinking about the electrons. In the what pattern? Let's get that. You go for this pattern. So what's there? So it is D x square y square equal to D z square greater than D x y equal to D y z
equal to d dx. So this is what will be happening in this one. So these are the three ways of splitting. See, in this there is no g in the triangle, and the difference in energy here, 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 there is a relation, right? The splitting of tetrahedral energy is 4 by 10 elements of octahedral energy. Splitting of square plana energy is equal to something like 4 by 3 of octahedral. Okay, let me check it once. So that is the difference in energy. What we can say, tetrahedral energy, square plana complexes, in that way there will be a splitting in the energy levels. Right. Right. Same that one. So tetrahedral, it is 4 by 9 times of octahedral. Square plana is 4 by 9 times of this one. So tetrahedral energy, this is tetrahedral energy. Splitting energy of tetrahedral complex is 4 by 9 times of octahedral. Splitting energy of square plana is 4 by 9 times of octahedral. So among these three, which splitting energy is greater? See, among these two, we can say this is greater. Among these two, this is more splitting. Okay? So, what will be the order? 4 by 9 times. So, it is the final splitting energy. Delta of splitting energy of square plana complex. If we take splitting energy of square plana greater than splitting energy of octahedral greater than splitting energy of tetrahedral. So this is the energy level patterns. I think you hope you have got this. These three should be in your mind. Octahedral two ways, EG and EG. Tetrahedral T2 and E. Square plana, it gets dissociated in this way. X square less than we have greater than xy. This square will be higher than this square, then this square equal. So if you compare the splitting energies of square plane operator and tetrahedral, this is the pattern. And how they are like tetrahedral is equal to 4 by 9 times of octahedral splitting energy, square plane splitting energy is equal to 4 by 3 of octahedral energy. Okay students, this is what for today. In the tomorrow session, we will be going with respect to the, our stereo isolation, that is geometrical as well as optical isolation. By the 90% topic will be completed. Only light and metal compounds will be happening. In this week, we will be completing this chapter. Okay, stay safe, stay home, have a nice day. Bye.